Hi there, my name is Patrick Baumgartner and I'm a group designer on Power BI, and today we're going to show a quick demo of Power BI Q&A and how you can use Power BI Q&A to ask questions and get answers and do quick analysis using search and natural language. Here we're looking at a Power BI site in Office 365, and what we've gone ahead and done is uploaded a data set, an Excel workbook that contains airline delay information, and we have some featured questions to get us started asking about flights and where we should fly, when we should fly, and get quick insight and analysis on flights. So here I just asked for the flights and the system returned a list of all the different flights in the database, but I'm in Seattle and it's a little dreary this time of year, so maybe I can look at setting up a vacation to Hawaii. So let's ask about the best way to fly from Seattle to Hawaii. So flights from Seattle to Hawaii by carrier. And what we can see now is the system is bringing back all the different destinations in Hawaii and all the different carriers that serve those destinations. And maybe you actually want to look at the with the number of flights per week. And so we saw that this is geocodable information, so we went out and asked Bing and helped put it on a map here so we can see the different destinations in Hawaii and how they're served by different carriers. The interesting thing about Q&A is since we have a deep understanding of the data we're looking at, we can actually come back and suggest other measures inside of the data that might be interesting to you. So instead of flights per week, the system's offering, maybe I want to look at the average arrival delay, the percent of late arrival, so we can look at the percent of flights to these destinations that are delayed. And instead of looking at this as a map, maybe we'll look at this as a bar chart. And again, I can just use natural language to go ahead and ask for this information. And we can see really quickly here that maybe, you know, the chance of being delayed to Honolulu is a little bit higher than if I'm flying to the Big Island or Maui. And so let's actually dive into that. Let's look at, you know, what island I should fly to and maybe when I should fly to it if I'm going to go ahead and take this vacation. So maybe we look at the percent of late arrival versus the average delay. And then maybe we want to look at this with the number of flights per week. Number of flights per week. And so I can still see this by carrier, but actually let's break it out by day of week. By day of week. And so now we can see the system's bringing back some small multiples here that are going to help me make my decision. And what I can see right off the bat is that, you know, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, later in the week, Wednesday, the flights are actually delayed much more frequently than on Sunday or Monday. You know, which is a bit unfortunate because you're missing the weekend on your vacation. But it looks like if I can leave Seattle early in the week on Sunday or Monday, I'll have a better chance of not getting a delay. And if there is a delay, it'll be a little bit smaller as compared to the end of the week. So that's actually pretty useful information to me. I really hate sitting on airplanes in general. And maybe this will be interesting information to somebody else. And so I could either just take this hyperlink and send it out, and other people with access to this site could follow that link right back to this result. Or I can feature this question. And so when I add a featured question, what I'm basically doing is saying, hey, this is something that's, when people come to this site, this is an interesting starting point for analysis. And I can go ahead and customize this here with a little bit of a look and feel. But to really get my point across, maybe I want to add an image here that really makes this answer pop. And so I can see this nice picture of Hawaii here. So I can save this. And now when people come back into the system on that main pager here, they can see this featured question and help them get started asking questions. The great thing about Q&A is this isn't a static answer. It's still interactive. So maybe instead of looking at Seattle, I could come here and look at Denver and just continue my analysis, asking different questions on this data set. And hopefully here you saw how Q&A is just a really quick way to do analysis and interact with data in a very natural way that hopefully lets this idea of analysis and getting insights from data makes it available to more users to do things like this. So thank you very much for your time. We're excited to hear about how you're doing with this product and so you can get some hands-on experiences. This is all available with Power BI. So thank you very much for your time. Goodbye.